Welcome to PyTorch Developer Day. My name is Christian Keller, and I'm the product manager for the on-device AI platform and PyTorch Mobile at Meta AI. Today, Linbin Yu and myself will present the uses of PyTorch Mobile at Meta scale. Today, we'll address two topics. First, PyTorch Mobile in numbers at Meta, followed by a deep dive in a use case with real-time person segmentation. Let's take a look at some high-level numbers first. Our journey started in 2019 with the launch of PyTorch Mobile at Developer Day. In 2020, we expanded our offering from simply inferencing on CPU to providing additional inferencing solutions on GPU for iOS and Android. In 2020, we saw a major uptick in PyTorch Mobile usage internally. We have now reached metascale for PyTorch Mobile usage and are excited to show you how far we've taken on-device AI. But first, what is on-device AI used for at Meta? Our usage covers a wide range of fields, from computer vision to language, speech, and ranking. The application domains also vary from augmented reality to integrity and commerce, to name a few. We have new teams showing interest in deploying AI on-device every day in new exciting fields. And now, let's look at how far we've taken some of these deployments. Where is PyTorch Mobile deployed? Today, we're in production on 15 surfaces on Android, iOS, Windows, macOS apps, including Facebook app, Instagram, and Messenger. We'll also deploy on creator apps like Spark AR and devices like Portal and Quest VR headsets. What is our reach? We have 1.4 billion monthly active devices deployed with PyTorch Mobile across those surfaces. These devices cover a wide range of hardware, going from high-end iOS and Android phones to older generation phones, delivering a consistent experience to our users across all of them. On those, we have 1.4 trillion inferences made monthly. To reach that scale, we have had to make PyTorch Mobile a reliable runtime, ready for scaling. These 1.4 trillion inferences power 45 billion individual product experiences, improving a wide range of products from video calling to creator tools and augmented reality. PyTorch Mobile is ready for your use cases, no matter the scale you're aiming for. Next, Linbin will talk about a specific use case, real-time person segmentation.
Hi, my name is Linbin Yu. I'm a software engineer at Meta. Today, I'm going to talk about a PyTorch Mobile use case, which is real-time person segmentation used in Meta. Person segmentation model can detect if there is a person in the image, and if so, which pixel belongs to the person and which pixel belongs to the background. Then we can replace the background image with something else. Person segmentation has been used in many Meta apps, including Facebook, Messenger, Instagram, Instagram Reels, and AR Spark Studio. For example, person segmentation was used in virtual background for a video call, and background blurring, and in many Spark AR effects. Those Spark AR effects can either be developed by Meta or by third-party developers using Spark AR Studio. There are different models to do person segmentation, but to use it at Meta scale, there are some challenges to overcome. The first one is latency. When we use person segmentation in a video chat or meeting, it must be real-time. That means the model must run very fast, ideally less than 20 milliseconds on most mobile phones. The second challenge is power consumption. When we use person segmentation in a video chat or in a meeting, it usually runs for a long time, like 30 minutes or even longer. If we don't control power consumption, the phone can easily be overheated or run out of battery. The third challenge is a unified experience on multiple platforms. The person segmentation model will be run on Android, iOS, macOS, and Windows, and the device can be very different. We want to use the same model to run everywhere, but the user experience must be the same. So how do we overcome these challenges? First, we develop a lightweighted model architecture based on FVNet v3, which is faster than the previous UNet-based model. And for low-end devices, we need to find a good trade-off between image quality and speed. So we generate a different model with lower resolution for these low-end devices. We also quantize the model. Quantization can greatly reduce the model size and latency. PyTorch Mobile supports two different quantization engines. For mobile devices, we can use QNMPack. For desktop, we can use FBGM. To reduce the power consumption, we can offload computation to GPU, NPU, or DSP on some devices using different PyTorch backend. PyTorch Mobile supports different backends, including Metal, CoreML, Vulkan, and NAPI. This allows us to better utilize GPU, NPU, and DSP on these mobile devices. For person segmentation model, we can convert it to different backend and deploy it to different devices. For certain iOS devices, we use PyTorch Metal backend to offload the computation to GPU. We are also testing a PyTorch CoreML backend to further reduce the power consumption and memory footprint. Similarly, for Android devices, we use PyTorch Vulkan backend to offload the computation to GPU. And we are testing Android NAPI backend to utilize DSP and NPU on certain devices. This is how we use person segmentation at Meta.
To get you started with PyTorch Mobile, you can go to our resources on our landing page in the pytorch.org website and ask us questions on the forums. Thank you for your time. We hope these examples demonstrated that PyTorch Mobile is ready to deploy at scale on your applications.